do is your structure, you know, that representation just by a dot structure. Okay, the valence electron you would represent by just by dot structure. So where you can find by seeing the dot structure, you will be able to find out the valence electron, as well as you will be able to find out the valency of the electron. In the sense, the combining capacity, how many electrons will go for combining, either sharing or losing or gaining. Okay, so that is nothing but do is dot structure. But that structure, I did not explain regarding the shape of the molecule. Okay, so the some of the drawbacks are there for Lewis dot structure that we'll see after the main concept, that is nothing but formal charge. Okay, so here what is mean by formal charge? Say in polyatomic molecules, when you are writing charges, for example, now you have sulfate, so for 2 minus, for whole molecule minus 2 will be the charge. For whole molecule, you are going to write the charges. That is nothing but for polyatomic molecules, you are going to write the charges, right? So if you are denoting the charges for a particular atom, okay, which is present in the molecule, okay, so that may be considered as formal charge. Okay, representation of the charges with a particular element, for a particular element based on the number of, electrons. Okay, so that will be considered as formal charge. Now to write this formal charge, we have to write Lewis dot structure for any molecule or compound. If you write Lewis dot structure, it is easy to identify what will be the formal charge. Okay, so first we'll take just one example. I'll take example of ozone. Okay, so ozone formula will come as O3, right? First we will write Lewis dot structure for ozone. Okay, so now oxygen, in the sense, we know electronic configuration, that is 1s2, 2s2, 2p4, right? So what will be the valence electron? 6. So 6 O3 in the sense into 3. So total 18 electron you need to distribute. So write Lewis dot structure. So that comes as, first write a skeletal diagram of O3. Okay, distribute 18 electron. So 1, 2, in the sense you need to give the bond, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Next for another, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Next, still 2 electrons, 17, 18. Okay, so over 18 electrons are distributed. Now, check the stability. This oxygen, 2, 4, 6, 8, stable. So this oxygen, 2, 4, 6, 8, stable. This oxygen, 2, 4, 6. So this oxygen is having only 6 electrons, in the sense it needs 2 electrons. So from where you are supposed to get from a stable atom? So this is stable, right? From this stable atom, you need to remove 2 electrons and you have to keep it in the middle, so that it may be shared by 2 oxygens. Okay? So you can either from here or from here. Okay, so I will just remove from this oxygen and I will keep in the middle. So that this oxygen 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The same way this oxygen 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, stable. So we can say in ozone, so these electrons will undergo for bonding, and here these electrons will go for bonding. So in between two oxygen you can see double bond, and these two oxygen will be having single bond. Okay, it can be vice versa also. Okay, so this is nothing but Lewis dot structure for ozone. To write formal charge, you need to write Lewis dot structure. You should know how many electrons a particular element will get. Okay, so which will go for bonding and which is there as non-bonding. So bonding electrons will be for bond. So which electrons are involved for bonding? So those are bonding electrons. Which electrons are not involved for bonding? So those electrons are non-bonding electrons. So we need bonding electrons as well as we need non-bonding electrons to write formal charge. For that sake, we are writing Lewis dot structure. So we will go for to find out the formal charge. So formal charge is equal to, write the formula. Formula carries 1 mark. So write down the formula. So the formula says like total number of valence electron in a free atom. It is the number of valence electron of a particular atom. Okay. Minus total electrons which will never undergo for bonding. So those electrons we are supposed to write. Minus half into total number of bonding electrons. So how many electrons are involved in the bonding? Okay, so that will be considered as bonding electron, right? So now here we have to write according to the formula. So what we have to do, see, formal charge when you are finding. In the sense, formal charge means what? You are going to find out the charge of each atom. In the sense, how many oxygens we have here? Three oxygens we have. So for three oxygen also, we need to find out the charge. I'll just consider, because all are same atom, for that reason, I'll just consider this oxygen as 1, this oxygen as 2, and another oxygen as 3. Okay? So I'll find out the formal charge for the first oxygen. Okay? So formal charge for oxygen, first oxygen I'll find it. Okay? So here, according to the formula, so what the formula says, total number of valence electrons in a free atom. So in this oxygen, what will be the total number of valence electrons? That is 6. Right? So 6 will be the valence electron. You know, valence electron of oxygen, that is nothing but 6. Okay? So 6 minus the total number of non-bonding electrons. According to this oxygen, what will be the total number of non-bonding electrons will not undergo for the bonding? Okay? So 2, 4, 6. So that is also 6 minus half into total number of bonding electrons. The electrons which will undergo for bonding in this first oxygen. So that is 2. So which will get cancelled with each other. Plus 6 minus 6 is 0. Right? So here, so this will be the formal charge of the first oxygen. Okay. So here we will go for the next one. So but here it's it. I mean here 2 1s and 2 1s are right. So 1 is there minus 1. 0 minus 1. So that is minus 1. So formal charge for first oxygen. So that will be minus 1. Please go see for the next one. That is for third one you said. Okay. You see for third one. So what will be the formal charge of the third oxygen? Okay. So here again the number of valence electrons, that is 6, minus the number of non-bonding electrons, that is 2, 4, minus half into here the number of bonded electrons, so that is also 4. So 2 2s are, so here 6 minus 4, that is nothing but 2. 2 minus 2, 0. So here the formal charge of this oxygen will be 0. So we go for the second one. So formal charge for second oxygen, how much it will be? See, the total number of valence electrons, that is 6, minus the total number of non-bonding electrons, that it just have 2 electrons, minus half into the total number of bonding electrons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So total 6 electrons are present. So 2 1s are, 2 3s are, 6 minus 3 again, here it is. 6 minus 2, 4 minus 3, that is nothing but 1. So according to formal charge, if you write, first write the skeletal diagram and according to its or structure, write the bond. Okay. So after that, whatever the formal charge you have written, that you have to represent. Okay. So you are supposed to write this concept also. Okay. So write for this oxygen, for the first oxygen, what is the formal charge? That is minus 1. So your charge will be minus 1. For this oxygen, that is second oxygen, what will be the formal charge? That is 1, which is nothing but plus 1, right? So what will be the formal charge of the third oxygen? So that is 0, 0, 2 into 5. Okay? So this will be the formal charge. So in the same way, they can ask for carbon dioxide, carbonate. So these are the ions for these kind of ions, and now they can ask for formal charge. Very important concept with the formal charge. So students, next we'll go for the drawbacks of Lewis dot structure. Okay. So the first drawback of Lewis dot structure, so that goes with incomplete octet of central atom and the second one is known as odd electron molecules, and the third one is expanded group. So one by one we will see these drawbacks are important. Okay, so now the first one, according to the first one, so it says that incomplete octet of central atom, in the sense central atom, okay, which will be having less number of 8 electrons. Okay, less number than 8 electrons. Incomplete octet, we see. For example, lithium chloride, beryllium chloride, boron trichloride. See, all these elements, these molecules will go for this drawback. Okay, so the first one, that is incomplete octet of central atom. So we will see with one example. Okay, now I take for example beryllium chloride. Okay, so here BeCl3. So beryllium, the central atom is beryllium, right? So beryllium, what will be the valence electron of beryllium? So that is 2. 2 will be the valence electron. If you go with the Cl, so there 7 electrons are the valence electron multiplied by 3, because Cl3, right? Okay. So how many electrons are you having? 21 electrons plus 2 electrons. So that is nothing but 23 electrons you need to distribute. Okay. So beryllium, 2 electrons that is having, and Cl, that is 7 electrons multiplied by 3. So total 21 electrons. Okay. When you total this, 23 electrons you need to distribute. Okay. So that is nothing but BeCl3. Beryllium dichloride also will belong to this kind of example. Okay, BeCl2 also. If I take BeCl2, see right down below the structure, according to see this action. Okay, so if I take BeCl2, beryllium dichloride, if I take what will happen, just multiply by 2 over here. 14 plus 2, that is 16 electron. Okay, so write down your structure and check. So for this, if I am writing you your structure, BeCl2, which will be the central atom? Beryllium will be the central atom, BeCl2, right? Distribute the number of electrons, that is something about 16 electrons you have to distribute. So they give here so that a bond formation takes place. So 1, 2, okay, then 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, okay, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, over 16 electrons you have distributed. Now you check with the, distribution of electron around Cl, so that goes with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, okay. Cl, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, okay, stable. This beryllium, if you check the central atom, 1, 2, 3, 4, how many electrons still it needs? 4 electrons it needs. You cannot get it from here, because when you write beryllium chloride structure, it just have a single bond around it. Okay, so single bond formation will take place around beryllium, not more than that. Double bond formation will not take place. Okay, so this we can say this beryllium will get lesser than 8 electrons. Incomplete octet will be seen. In the same way, you can check the lithium chloride. Okay, BeCl3, you can all BeCl2 you write and check. Okay, because beryllium charge according to that plus 2 here minus 1, this cross it will go. So BeCl2 will be the proper molecule for this. Right, this kind of structure you are going to get. Okay, so here incomplete octet will be seen in the case of beryllium. If you go to the lithium chloride, same thing will happen. What will be the valence electron of lithium? That is 1. What will be the valence electron of Cl? That is 7. 7 plus 1, that is 8. For lithium chloride, when you are giving electron, 8 electrons of Cl cannot be in the middle. Right? How you are supposed to give? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Over, right? So if you go with the chlorine, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, yes, chlorine is stable. But if you go with the lithium, it just has 2 electrons. Whether it is possible to give 6 electrons, anywhere you have seen that 6 bond formation will be there between the molecules? No, it is not there. Single bond, double bond, more in the sense, triple bond formation. So this kind of drawbacks will be seen in Lewis dot structure. So that is nothing but incomplete octet of central atom. So central atom will get lesser number of electrons, lesser than 8 electrons will be seen in central atom. Okay, so that is nothing but incomplete octet. Okay, so next will go with the odd electron molecules. Odd electron in the sense there it will be the number of electrons will be odd. Okay, odd number of electrons will be seen. If we consider nitrogen oxide, nitrogen valence electron is 7. If you go with oxygen, that is 6. Total 13 electrons you have to distribute. Odd electron. Whether it is possible to distribute this odd electron? NO. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Now, how you will balance this one electron? Whether it is possible to balance this electron to make it stable? No, it is not possible. You cannot give it. You are showing this as two electrons you are going to remove and you are going to keep it in the middle. Not one electron. Single electron, it is not possible. So, this will be considered as a drawback. Okay, so odd electron molecule. Next one, expanded rule. So, expanded rule, okay. Expanded in the sense that central atom will be having more number of electrons. For example, if you consider phosphorus pentachloride, phosphorus trichloride, SF6, SF8, all these things, all these molecules will come under this, okay. Sulfur chloride. So, all these molecules will come under expanded rule. Now, I consider one of the examples, okay. Sulfur, if you see the valence electron that is 6, okay, as well as fluorine, their valence electron it is 7, which will be multiplied by 6, so 42, so total 48 electrons you have to distribute, okay. So now, sulfur is the central atom because the resting number distributes fluorine 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 fluorine, this will be 48 electrons. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, here bond formation 5, 6, here 7, 8, here 9, 10, 9, 10, and between this 11, 12. Okay, so that a bond formation will take place between these. 12 over, next we form the, these atoms. 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, okay, 48. So here if you check the number of electrons, in this case, the number of electrons that will be more, it is stable. If you go with sulfur, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, so sulfur will have more than 8 electrons. But SF6 is the same molecule, okay? But it doesn't go with the Lewis dot structure. According to Lewis dot structure, according to the symbol, what this is, when you write the Lewis dot structure, by that each atom should get stable or the stability will be done by getting 8 electrons in its outermost shell. So here, according to that, the sulfur it doesn't obey the rule. The sulfur will get 12 number of electrons around 8. Okay. So according to Lewis dot structure, now this is unstable molecule, right? But it is not. SF6 is a stable molecule. So for that reason, these three laws will be considered as drawbacks of Lewis dot structure. So when it is incomplete octet, which will be having central atom will be having lesser than 8 electron, odd electron molecule, the number of electrons will be odd in number. Okay. Expanded rule, the central atom will be having more than 8 electrons. So that will be considered as expanded rule. So not only these three are very important drawbacks. Other two drawbacks are there, so that is nothing but this Lewis dot structure, it doesn't explain the proper shape of the molecule, proper stability of the molecule as well as energy of the molecule. Okay? So will not be explained by Lewis dot structure. That is fourth. Next drawback, so that is nothing but so mainly this law has been explained. This theory has been explained mainly based on noble gas, the inertness of noble gas, right? Because it will not going to combine with one another because those are stable. Why it is stable? Its glass shells are filled with 8 electrons. It is having 8 electrons in its outermost shell, so it will never go for bonding, right? But according to the, I mean, in environment, if you go with the some of the molecules, according to that, we can find some of the molecules which is formed with your noble gas. Okay, so it is possible that we can combine your noble gas with oxygen or fluorine, so that the molecule formation will take place along with it. Okay, so molecule formation will be possible with your noble gases. This concept, why it is possible with the noble gases? Okay, so these concepts have not been explained by using more this is not structure. Okay, so according to the theory, noble gas, according to noble gas, it is stable due to the filling of 8 electrons in each of the molecule. Based on that, this theory has been explained. But this will be considered as a drawback. The thing is, noble gas also can combine with oxygen as well as fluorine, okay, to form a molecule. If it is stable, why it will go and combine with oxygen as well as fluorine, right? So this will be considered as another drawback of Lewis dot structure. So this is regarding the Lewis dot theory, as well as the drawbacks of Lewis dot structure.